Greetings to you all in the name of Jesus Christ. Hope everyone are doing well at your homes, praying together and meditating the word of God. And this is the right time for us to grow in Christ. And today I would love to share the word about repentance and fruits worthy of repentance. Let's open our Bibles unto Gospel Matthew, 3rd chapter from 1st verse. In those days came John the Baptist, preaching in the wilderness of Judea, and saying, "Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." Here, John the Baptist is preaching. He's preaching about repentance. The main theme of his preaching is repentance. The intention of his preaching is about repentance. What is the meaning of repentance? What do you understand about repentance? Repentance means turning away from sin and turning towards God. When John the Baptist is preaching about repentance, and you can see here in the 5th verse, "Then went out to him Jerusalem and all Judea and all the region round about Jordan, and were baptized of him in Jordan, confessing their sins." When he was preaching about repentance, he asked people, when he preached about repentance, at the same time he asked people to get baptized for repentance. When he preached about repentance, people started to come and to get baptized for repentance. And there came people from Jerusalem, from Judah, and from the regions around about Jordan. And when we see people, when people started to come and when they started to get baptized, when the people are coming to get baptized for repentance, and there came also the people in the 7th verse, "When he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees coming to his baptism, he said unto them, O generation of vipers, who hath warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bring forth therefore fruits meet for repentance." There came a lot of people, there came much people to get baptized for repentance. They responded to the preaching of John the Baptist. When he was preaching about repentance, and when he asked to get baptized for repentance, people came to get baptized. And there also came people, Pharisees and Sadducees. When he saw these Pharisees and Sadducees, he spoke to them and he said, "O generation of vipers, who hath warned you to flee from the wrath to come?" And he said, "Bring therefore fruits worthy of repentance." To get baptized is not important, but what his intention was. If you get baptized, you need to bear fruits worthy of repentance. To get repentance, or when you repent, it's also important for us to have fruits worthy of repentance. When Pharisees and Sadducees came there, he said these words to them, that if you come here for baptism, that means it's also important for you to bear fruits worthy of repentance. And when we look in Gospel Luke, 3rd chapter, from 7th verse, "Then said he to the multitude that came forth to be baptized of him, O generation of vipers, who hath warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bring forth therefore fruits worthy of repentance." And when he spoke these words, he meant why they come there. When Pharisees and Sadducees came there, and immediately in the Luke 3rd chapter and 8th verse, he said, "And begin not to say within yourself, We have Abraham to our father. For I say unto you that God is able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham." These Pharisees and Sadducees came with all the people who have come there. There have come people from Jerusalem, from Judah, and from regions of Jordan. Even with joining these people, there came Pharisees and Sadducees. When they came, John the Baptist is speaking to them that, don't think within yourself that your father is Abraham. Being your father is Abraham, this is baptism is not that your father is Abraham. This baptism is for repentance. Repentance, if you are getting this baptism of repentance, that means confessing your sins And this baptism is for the remission of sins. And if you see here in the third chapter of Luke, third verse, and he came into all the country about Jordan preaching the baptism of repentance for the remission of sins. If you are getting baptized, that means you have to confess your sins for the remission of sins. You have to confess. In Gospel Matthew, he speaks about confession of sins. In Gospel Luke, he speaks about remission of sins. If you are getting baptized, you mean that you are confessing your sins for the remission of sins, for the remission. Here, when he spoke these words to the people, Gospel Luke 3rd chapter and 10th verse, and the people asked him, saying, "What shall we do then?" Here from 11th verse to 14th verse, you can see there are three sections of people. In the first, when he spoke this word, he said, if you have two coats, give one coat to others who are in need. And in the second, in the 15th verse, he speaks about the publicans. If the tax what you collect from people, it should be the tax which you are imposed to collect. If you collect the tax which is above the impose, that means it is not the fruit of repentance. And third thing, to the soldiers, when soldiers asked him, you are not supposed to use your power to make money, but you are supposed to make your powers worthy what you are supposed to do. You should not take much of your power as advantage to ruin the lives of people, but you have to make your duty proper. That's what the intention. And what we understand about fruits worthy of repentance, let's open towards our Bibles unto Acts, book of Acts 26th chapter 28th verse 26:20 Acts. But you first unto them of Damascus and at Jerusalem and throughout all the coasts of Judah, and then to the Gentiles, that they should repent and turn to God and do works meet for repentance. What we understand fruits of repentance is, fruits worthy of repentance is works that meet of repentance. Fruits, bearing fruits means that we show the action, we show. If we repent, that means we need to show it in action. We should show it in work. So that's what John the Baptist meant. You have to, therefore, bear fruit worthy of repentance. Here, you need to have works for repentance. And when we see here, when John the Baptist is preaching about repentance, people started to come and they started to confess their sins and they are baptized for repentance. And when he continued to preach, there came and with joining to them Pharisees and Sadducees. These two people, Pharisees are the people who follow customs, who follow traditions. They are much interested in customs and traditions than to understand the word of God, than to understand and follow the word of God, than to understand to practice the word of God. Their intention is, their interest is towards custom and traditions. And these Sadducees are the people who are logical and who are interested, and they are most practical thinking people. These Pharisees are the people who believe in resurrection, who believe in angels, and who believe in demons. And the Sadducees are the people who doesn't believe in resurrection, who doesn't believe in angels and miracles. But these Pharisees believe in resurrection, angels, and demons. And Sadducees are the people who believe in Mosaic law, or who believe in the law of Moses. And these are the logical people. And for example, to understand, Pharisees are the people are like our grandparents, who are much who stick on to our customs and traditions. And these Sadducees are people like our generation, who always think practically who are much interested in logics. These are two kinds of people we see, that Pharisees and Sadducees. When Pharisees and Sadducees came to John the Baptist to get baptized, and he said, "O generation of vipers, who hath warned you to flee from the wrath to come?" So when they came, he is not interested to give them baptism of repentance, but he's asking them that you have to bear fruits for the repentance. That means you have to show your work for repentance. And when we see, let's look to Gospel John, 8th chapter, 31st verse. "If you continue in my word, then are you my disciples indeed. And you shall know the truth, and truth shall make you free." They answered him, We be Abraham's seed, and we were never in bondage to any man. How sayest thou you shall be made free?" Here Jesus is speaking, "If you continue in my word, you will be my disciples. And you shall know the truth, and truth shall set you free. If you continue in my word, you will be my disciples. And you will know the truth, and truth will set you free." When he spoke these words, and the people answered, "We are not bondage to anyone. We are not slaves to anyone. We are Abraham's seeds." Then Jesus spoke. 37th verse of Gospel John 8th chapter. "I know that you are Abraham's seed, but you seek to kill me because my word hath no place in you. I speak that which I have seen with my father, and you do that which you have seen with your father." Here Jesus is telling them that, "I know you are Abraham's seed. You are the children of Abraham, I know. But I see my word has no place in you." And he speaks in the 39th verse, "If you were Abraham's children, you would do the works of Abraham." Being children of Abraham is not important. If you are the children of Abraham, you have to do the works of Abraham. Jesus spoke these words. If you are the children of Abraham, you have to do the works of Abraham. When he spoke this word, in the 40th verse, "But now you seek to kill me, a man that had told you the truth, which I have heard of God, that did not Abraham. You do the deeds of your father." Yes, you are true. If you are the children of Abraham, you have to do the works of Abraham. But you are doing the deeds of your father. And what do you understand? What we need to understand, who is the father of their works, is coming to the 49th verse. Jesus answered, "I have not a devil, but I honor my father, and you do dishonor me." I have no devil. I honor my father, but you dishonor me. I do the works of Father. I do the works of God. I have no devil, but you dishonor me. And speaking about their father, in the 44th verse, Gospel John 8th chapter 44th verse, "You're of your father the devil, and the lust of your father you will do." When Jesus means about their father is devil. They're having the lust, they're having the sinful path that is from the father, that is the devil. If you are the children of Abraham, you will do the works of Abraham. If you are children of devil, you will do the works of devil. So when you understand about bearing fruits worthy of repentance, is doing the works of Abraham. If you say within yourself that my father is Abraham, that means you have to do the works of Abraham. Physical children of Abraham is not important. What if you are the children of Abraham? You have to do the works of Abraham. If you are getting baptized for repentance, that means you have to do the works of Abraham. That means you have to do the works worthy of repentance. That means you have to walk in the paths of God. You have to obey the commandments of God. So if we understand what is the works of Abraham, let's turn to Hebrews 11th chapter, 8th verse. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed, and he went out, not knowing whither he went. Here, when God spoke to Abraham, what Abraham did is he obeyed God. That is the work of Abraham. What is the work of Abraham is when God spoke something to Abraham, he did it. He obeyed God. Without knowing, he started his journey. Without knowing the place, without knowing the place where he is going, but he started his journey. First, what he did is he obeyed God. Let's open 1 Samuel. Fifteenth chapter, 22nd verse. And Samuel said, "Had the Lord has great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifice as in obeying the voice of the Lord. Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hear than the fat of rams." What is important is to obey. Obey is better than sacrifice. Obey is better than offerings. What we need to understand is obedience, that is the work of Abraham. What if you repent? That means you need to understand you have to turn away from sin and you have to turn towards God. You have to obey God. You have to hear the voice of God. You have to hear and follow the commandments of God. And let's open book of Acts, 2nd chapter, 38th verse. Then Peter said unto them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost." On the day of Pentecost, when they were filled with the Holy Spirit, when all the people saw the great anointing, the great fire, and when the people started to speak tongues, they were amazed. And when they saw this, and Peter stood up and spoke boldly. When he is speaking revelations from the book of Joel, and people understood this is from God. And when he spoke this word, their hearts were pricked. When their hearts were pricked and they asked, "What shall we do?" Then Peter spoke, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sin. Every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit." What you have to do? Repent and be baptized in the name of the Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you will receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit. So today, if you repent, that means you have to turn away from sins and you have to turn towards God. For the repentance, you have to get baptized. And in the book of Acts, 19th chapter, from 4th verse, then said Paul, "John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him, that is, on Christ Jesus. When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul had laid his hands upon them, the Holy Spirit came on them, and they spoke with tongues and prophesied." And here, Apostle Paul, in the city of Ephesus, when he came there, when he asked them, "Are you baptized?" They said, "Yes, we are baptized to the baptism of repentance, to the baptism of John." Then Paul said, "Baptism of John is for the baptism of repentance. But what we need today is we need to get baptized in the name of Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit." When we are baptized in Jesus' name, then He will pour His Spirit on us. Today we need to receive the power of the Holy Spirit. Why we need the power of the Holy Spirit is to do the will of Father, to do the will of God, to proclaim the word of God, to proclaim gospel, gospel, when we understand gospel, gospel came not in word but also in the power of the Holy Spirit. Today, when we proclaim gospel, today if you want to proclaim, if you want to preach gospel, what we need today is we need to get baptized in the power of the Holy Spirit. We need the anointing of the Holy Spirit. We need the power of God. We need the great joy of the Holy Spirit. Today, what we need to understand is today repentance. Today you have to turn to God. You have to turn away from sin and you have to turn to God. You have to bear the fruit of repentance. You have to bear, you have to do the works which meet for repentance. And that's what the word of God is speaking. Today, if you are ready, if you want, if you, this is the right time, this is a very, if you are staying at your homes and you are praying, a lot of people started to pray. A lot of people, a lot of families came together to meditate the word of God. Still, there are few people, there are many who are neglecting the word of God, who are neglecting the presence of God, who are not coming still to the word of God. But this is the time to understand that we have no time. This is the time that God is near unto you. You have to understand that this is the time that God will speak to you, and this is the right time to get saved. That's what we need to understand. And this is the right time. If you are not yet baptized, if you are not yet into Christ, this is the right time. Ask God, Lord, I am a sinful man. I am a sinner. Forgive my sins. Cleanse me, Lord. I come, Lord. I confess my sins. If you confess your sins, and when you repent, then you will see the remission of sins. And if you are ready, and when this lockdown is open, then start striving for the baptism. And this is the right time. Let's give our hearts to God. And what God is expecting from us is obedience, because obedience is better than sacrifice. Obedience is better than burnt offerings. Obedience is better than your offering. What God is expecting from you is not offering, but God is expecting your obedience. What you have to do today is obey God, hear the voice of God, hear and walk according to the word of God. And let's make a decision that, Lord, I confess my sins. From today, Lord, I strive to live for you. I strive to obey your word, O Lord. Help me, Lord, to do God's will. You need the power of the Holy Spirit. Ask God for his anointing and he will pour his spirit upon you. And let's pray today, Lord, forgive me. And he's ready to forgive you. And if you are saved, and this is time for us to preach the word of God to your families, to your relatives, and God will open his great anointing on their lives, and God will open the eyes of them, and God will open the eyes of their hearts. And let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for this wonderful time. Lord, I pray for all the people who are listening to this word. Help us, O Lord, to bear the fruits worthy of repentance. Help us to do the works worthy of repentance. Help us, O Lord. Help us, people who are not yet turned away from sin. Help them, O Lord. Let your Spirit lead them and help them to confess their sins and turn unto you, Lord. Lord Jesus, help them and guide them. Thank you, Lord. And I proclaim blessing on every life. Lord, I pray for the, Lord, pray for the people who are affected by coronavirus. Heal them, O Lord. Heal my nation. Heal my country, Lord. Lord, forgive my country. Forgive my city. Forgive my state, Lord. And let your healing be upon our country and your name be blessed. And all glory and honor to you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. God bless you.